Hello and welcome. I'm Raghav and today we are going to learn about comparison or relational operators in JavaScript. We have seen there are different types of operators and we have learned about arithmetic and assignment operators in the last session, and today we are going to discuss and learn about comparison operators. So in JavaScript we have different comparison operators like equals to, which is represented by a double equal sign. If I go to my Visual Studio Code and I will go to the operator.js file that we created earlier, and in the last session we discussed about assignment operators. Let me just comment this out by selecting this and pressing Control and forward slash or Command and forward slash on the keyboard in case of Mac, and I will give a heading here. So here this is comparison operators. Now here if I say I'll give two variables, I will say let x equals 10 and let y equals 20. Now if I say x equals equals y, so here I'm comparing the value of x and y by using this comparison operator, that is double equals to, and I can also print out the result and I can also store this in some variable. So I can say let result equals x equals equals y, so whatever is the result, true or false, will be stored in result, and then I can just print out the result. So I will say result here, and if I run this, let us see the output. So I'm getting false because x and y are not equal, and instead of storing it separately and then printing, I can also directly print out in console.output. I can say x equals equals y, so whatever is the output of this expression, true or false, will get printed out. So if I run this again, I should get the same response. Let me just check this again and I'll run this again, and yes, I'm getting false. Now here if I say y equals 10, however I'm making it as a string. Now if you see, x is a number or an integer and y is a string, however the value for both of these variable is same. So if I run this statement x equals equals y, let us see the output, and here let me just check this again. I'll run this again and yes, we are getting true. So that means with double equals to, it only checks the value and not the type. So we have another operator which is triple equals, which will also check the type. So this will check value as well as type. So if I just say triple equals here and I run this, this time I should get false because the type is not same. So we have this operator, then we have not equals to. If I use exclamation mark and equals, this is not equals to. So if x is not equals to y, then I will get true, otherwise I will get false. Now if I see, I am getting false. This is because the value is same. If I use double equals with exclamation, now this will also check value as well as type. So if I run this now, this time I should get true, that means x is not equals to y, and we are getting true this time. So we have not equals to, and we have seen not equal to value and type, and then we have greater than and less than. So this is the symbol for greater than. If I say x greater than y and I'll run this, so here I'm getting false because x and y are equal, and of course you can see it is just checking the value, not the type. So I can just make it like this, and if I say x less than y, again I should be getting false because both of them are equal. I can also use equals with greater than or equals, greater than or less than. This will mean if x is less than or equals to y, then I will get true. So because x and y are equal, this time I should be getting true. Similarly, I can say if x is greater than or equals to y, this will again give me a true. So I'm getting true here. So we can use greater than or equals, less than or equals, and then we have a ternary operator as well. So what is a ternary operator? Let me just explain it to you very quickly. So here we have a ternary operator, and it is like if then else statement, and I will just show you how to use it. Takes three arguments, so it takes three arguments, and the syntax is, we can have some condition and then a question mark, and then value if the condition is true and value if the condition is false. So we will have a condition, it will compute the condition here. If the result is true, it will go here, and whatever value or expression we have here, we can also have some expression, and whatever is the result will be returned from here. Let me make it simple for now. And in case the condition is false, the value from here after the colon will be returned. So let me show you an example. I take a condition x is greater than y and I give a question mark. So that means if the condition is true, then I should return x colon y. So here I am saying compute x greater than y expression. If the expression returns true, then return x, and if this expression or condition is false, then return y. I can also just store it in some variable. I can say let result equals this, and then I will print out the result. So I will say result, and that's it. So let me make x equals to 11 and y is 10, and if I run this now, let us see the output. So I'm getting 11, so that means this is working fine. If I make y as 12 and now run the same expression again, this should give me 12. So yes, I'm getting 12. So this is how you can use ternary operator, and it is like a short form of if then and else. So these are all the comparison operators, and in the next session I will discuss more on operators and different types of operators. I hope this was very useful for you. Thank you for watching.